Hello all. Today we are going to talk about logic gates and their various properties. The outline of my presentation is we will be looking at the basic gates such as NOT gate, AND gate, OR gate, properties of AND and OR gates, then XOR gate, XNOR gate, NOR gate, NAND gate, and finally look at what is De Morgan's theorem. The first basic gate is known as NOT gate or inverter. As you can see from the logic diagram, the symbol of NOT gate looks like this. The logic equation goes, Q is my output, A is my input. So the logic equation is Q is equal to A bar. That means my output is inversion of my input A. On this lines, the truth table of NOT gate is something like this. If I give 0, I will get 1. If I give logic 1, I will get logic 0. That means the output is always the inverted version of the input. Hence, a NOT gate can also be called as inverter. Now, let's look at our second gate, which is AND gate. AND gate can be analyzed in the form of a electrical circuit consisting of two switches. If I say A and B are my two switches, then in order to get the logic notation for the AND gate, which is A into B is equal to C, where C is my output, will be the arrangement of the switches will be like this. That means in order for the current to flow, my both the switches should be in the closed position or in the on position. Then only I will get the output. In other words, I will get the output, that is logic 1. AND gate logic symbol is something like this, where A and B are my inputs and C is my output. The truth table of the AND gate is as follows. When A and B both are at low level, that is 0, 0, my output is 0. When one of the input is at logic 1, then also I will get the output as 0. That is the third case also, I am getting output as 0. Only when both the inputs are 1, then only I will get the output high. In other words, this is the exact replica of my electrical circuit consisting of two switches. When both are 1 or when both the switches are closed, I get the output equal to 1. Now, let's look at our third gate, which is a OR gate. Now, OR gate can also be analyzed in terms of electrical circuit having a switches in which my switches are connected in parallel. So here what happens is that even if one of the switch is closed and the other one is open, I will still get the output as high. I will get a high output when both the switches are closed. I will get a low output when both the switches are open. So the truth table exactly replicates the same thing. When both are open, I will get the output as no output. When one of the switches is also closed, I will get the output as logic 1. When both are closed, obviously I will get the output as logic 1. So this is the truth table of my OR gate. The logic symbol of my OR gate is as shown. A and B are my inputs and C is my output. Now, properties of AND and OR gate. The first property is commutation property, which tells that the order of the variables appearing in the logic equation doesn't matter. In other words, A plus B is equal to B plus A. In terms of AND, A dot B is equal to B dot A. If I have to look in terms of the logic symbols, same commutation law, it looks something like this. And for OR gate, it is like this. The second commutation property circuit can be analyzed in terms of electrical A dot B, two switches, B dot A, same. Similarly, A or B is same as B or A. So, this is the electrical analysis of the logic equation. The next property of AND and OR is associative property. It simply states that the position of the brackets appearing in the logic equation doesn't matter and both sides the logic equation will be same. That is A or B plus C equals A or B or C. So this is the electrical analysis of associative property, left hand side and right hand side. So both my outputs would be equal. And in terms of AND gate, this is what is my associative property looks like. Now next gate is XOR gate or exclusive OR gate. The logic symbol of exclusive OR gate is as shown on the slide, either A or B but not both. What it means that the output of the XOR gate will be logic 1 if one of the inputs are 1. That is, if there are unequal or indifferent inputs, I will get the output as logic 1. When both the inputs are same, that is, when both the inputs are not same, I will get logic 1. When both the inputs are same, I will get logic 0. This exclusive OR is also known as inequality detector because result will be 0 when the inputs are same and 1 when they are different. So this is the truth table of my exclusive OR. When both inputs are same, I will get the output as logic 0. Here also, when both the inputs are same, I will get the output as 0. Only when the inputs are indifferent, I get the output as logic 1. This is what is the operation of XOR gate or exclusive OR gate. And this is the logic equation of my XOR gate. A bar dot B plus A dot B bar. Exclusive OR can be extended a bit with a exclusive NOR. It is same as XOR but only with a complement. In other words, my equation for XNOR will be exactly the opposite to that of XOR. As a result, the truth table is also different and exactly reverse of that of XOR. So when both the inputs are same, I will get the output as logic 1. When both the inputs are different, I will get the output as logic 0. Here my inputs are same, so I am getting the output as logic 1. This is an equality detector. The next gate is a NOR gate, which is actually not OR gate. Not OR gate is the complement of the OR gate. So A OR B, the whole complement, is the equation of my NOR gate. The truth table is exactly opposite to that of the OR gate. Next is NAND gate. In NAND gate, my equation is A dot B the whole bar. That means it is a complement of the AND gate. As a result, the truth table of the NAND gate will be exactly opposite to that of the AND gate. Now, one thing you have to note that NAND and NOR gates are called universal gates, because any basic gate can be constructed using only these two gates. That's why the name universal gates to NAND and NOR gates. Now, there is a very important theorem which is known as De Morgan's theorem. It can be stated in this way. It states that the complement of the AND equals the sum of the individual complements. In other words, a NAND gate is equivalent to inversion followed by an OR gate. That means A dot B the whole bar equals A bar plus B bar. Or another version of the NAND De Morgan's theorem in terms of NOR gate is the complement of the OR equals the AND of individual complements. So in terms of gates, a NOR gate is equivalent to an inversion followed by AND gate. This is the De Morgan's truth table, as you can see. Now, references for this presentation are taken from google.com. Thank you so much for listening.